Done with Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, all hail Kyle Sauerland. Say it again. All hail Kyle Sauerland. If you don't know who that is, it's the main man behind all these WBSS tournaments, right, that are going on. If you don't know what that is, those are the tournaments who we find out who is the best in these divisions, right? Everything that we love in boxing, when all of the baddest dudes get together and have a tournament to find out who's the best. And at the end, they get a whole lot of money and the Muhammad Ali trophy. And a trophy got to be important if a Muhammad Ali name is on it. I think this is a great thing. It then gave us already, it just started, what, a year and a half ago? What has it given us? An undisputed, right? Let's say that word. Undisputed cruiserweight champion in Alexander Usyk, right? And let me tell you guys, everybody who was somebody was in that cruiserweight tournament that Alexander Usyk won, right? We know he's going to fight Tony Bellew coming up soon. But everybody was there. Now, they had a super middleweight tournament. Pretty good. You know, wasn't everybody there. I think Ramirez wasn't there. And when James DeGale was James DeGale, when it was important, he wasn't there, right? Because he was hurt at the time. But most the best of the best. So now what we got on the weekend, you know, we got what the tournament in junior middleweight, the junior welterweight division, 140-pound division. Bad dudes are in there. And we don't know them all, right? But the bad dudes in there. Now, Regis Prograis, right? One of the favorites. He ain't the only favorite. Ivan Baranchik is another one, right? But one of the favorites is fighting first time or not too many times in no fight, but he fought in his home, New Orleans, right? And he beat your boy Terry Flanagan, right? Unanimous decision, one-way traffic. But let me tell you something. Good fight, because Flanagan wasn't having. Flanagan was knocked down. For the first time in his career, Flanagan has fought about 35 times, only losing one fight, guys, to Maurice Hooker recently in his home backyard, which is a good win for Maurice Hooker. Kudos to him. But Flanagan, everyone knows, is a tough cookie. He ain't never been down. And after being down in round 8, still can't got up and handled his business and was trying all the way to the end of that fight, right? He lost, you know, pretty much every round. But you know, I would give him maybe like 2 rounds in that whole fight. Your boy, Regis Prograis, looks awesome. Let me tell you something. He looks awesome. You know, he's got it all. I thought it was just only a Mike Tyson type, you know, going to come forward. Because that's what he does against guys who don't have that punch of power. But he can box. Got extremely good upper body movement. And let me tell you, the word that sticks with me when looking at this guy is poise. I mean, after he knocked old boy down, when you carry this kind of punch of power, you knock somebody down, normally you're going to go off and get him. He was poised. And he should have been, because Flanagan was hitting him with some things. After being down, Flanagan showed what it is to be a champion. Showed. Flanagan, I was impressed with, you know, see, I can get impressed with people who lose fights. Flanagan reminds me of, you know, look at my favorite basketball player. Y'all know it. It's Hakeem Olajuwon. And when they was, you know, the sixth seed back in the 90s, about 94 or 96, I'm not sure what year, there was a sixth seed in the West, right? Six seeds don't go to the finals and definitely don't go win the NBA championships. But when they did that, after they did that, their coach, Rudy Tomjanovich, said, never, ever underestimate the heart of a champion because they had won the year before. You know what I'm saying? So that's what happened there. And that statement is profound. Flanagan wasn't winning many other rounds. Got knocked down in round 8, was still trying to do what he was trying to do. Hitting, matter of fact, Prograis with some nice shots when Prograis was coming in there. So Prograis just said, okay, I'm going to just chill. You know, see what I can do. Stay behind the jab. Get in here when I can, and if not, whatever. You know, good stuff. Regis Prograis is one of the favorites of the tournament for sure. And, you know, it's something else. You know, he's going to be a problem. You know, all the people talking about we're going to go up to 140 and all that stuff. Be careful what you ask for. You might not want to mess up with this dude here. I don't see him being too much effective at 147 because he's not that tall. But with that skill, who knows? Who knows? Prograis is a problem going forward. Let's see what happens. You know, he fights in his next fight. He's going to fight your boy Carol Relic, which is not going to be easy. And then, you know, because this was the quarters, they're going to go into the semis. And Ivan Baranchek beat Anthony Gigot, and he stopped him, right? He stopped him. So he's going to fight the winner of Josh Taylor and a guy named Ryan Martin next week, because the WBWS tournament, it goes all over the world. You talk, we're going from New Orleans, we're going to Scotland over to Josh Taylor's place, and we're going to have some fights over there. That's what this WBWS tournament, that's why all hail Kylie Sauerland, trying to find out who the best are, you know, and it's this 140-pound division. Most of the guys are there. Like I said, Morris Hooker upset your boy Flanagan over at his crib. But he was, you know, like they do, mandated to fight Alex Salcido right away, right? Just got the title, right? Mandated to fight this dude right away. They can't enjoy the title. Is that what they did to Canelo when he win it? No, they didn't. And Canelo didn't have to go away to win nothing. He didn't have to go where Golovkin would have liked to fight. Right? But this dude, Morris Hooker, well, you go fight the next dude right away. And another cat, Jose Ramirez, he's not there. Other than that, everybody who is somebody in the 140-pound division is there. If you know, you count Adrian Broner, but we ain't. So this is going down. All hell kind of Sourland for people who like to see things like Undisputed, right? When everybody else is working for it not to be happening. You know, if it's sanctioning bodies, if it's promoters, and people feeling entitled, and people who wouldn't even enter tournaments like that. I'm not going to get into that this video. But let me tell you, these guys are entered. Let's get behind things like this. Just because Carly Sauerland is someone we don't know and traditionally know that they're the ones that's supposed to be making fights, whatever. This is a guy who we can, if we want to get Undisputed, and that's our goal in a lot of divisions, then maybe we need to follow what's going on in the WBWS tournament. Alexander Usyk is already undisputed, and we're working for the other ones. I think that's what Regis Progress is trying to do, and I'm pretty sure that's what Baranchek's trying to do too. So let's see what happens. Doma Sports Talk, worldwide, and I'm about it there, y'all.